Back now at 8:45 with this morning's American Story with Bob Dodson. It comes from Rushville, Illinois, where people are celebrating 55 reasons to be thankful this holiday season. That's the number of years a doctor has been looking after his neighbors, charging about what a lot of folks pay for a cup of coffee.
Rushville, Illinois is the kind of place where squirrels grow fat even in winter. And caring is as constant as the seasons.
Much coffee? A little bit.
Dr. Russell Doner has been looking after his neighbors for 55 years.
Yeah, what's Matthew Bill?
In all that time, he has not taken a vacation, not even a full day off.
There's always somebody on Sunday that needs some help too.
The morning we first met back in 1983, he had been to surgery twice, prepped a broken arm, handled two emergency cases, checked on 50 patients, and delivered three babies.
Looks like one of yours, doesn't it?
It was not yet 10:30.
It's a little girl.
Here is Megan Thompson today with her niece, Piper.
How old do you think he is?
35.
Doc was born 85 years ago on a nearby farm, one of seven children. He worked nights to pay his way through Northwestern University Medical School. Had his heart set on being a big city cardiologist, but decided,
I've got to take care of my people first. Yeah.
Everyone pays just $5 to see him.
Is that all?
Yes.
$5. Doc doesn't toss away a tool just because it has a few years on it. That keeps costs down.
You ever see rotary phones anywhere?
The only thing modern in his clinic is his medicine. Most of his nurses have been with him nearly as long as his furniture.
How can you make it on $5 a patient?
Millions and millions of patients frequently.
If they can't come to him, he goes to them.
I wanted to see old Margie. Is she here too?
Yeah, she's sitting right over there.
Oh, good.
Perhaps that's why Bill Bartlow is still nimble enough to play the organ at 90. His wife, Margie, just got home from the hospital.
You're doing pretty good now, so that's good. Let's just keep it up.
Doc will go anywhere for a house call, often arriving before emergency services. He once saved the life of a small boy who was smothering to death in a corn crib, climbed down into a coal mine to help rescue four men, broke his own back and suffered a heart attack a few years ago, took some time off until patients started arriving at his house seeking medical care.
Probably gastroenteritis, doesn't he? That's what it's got to be if I take care of what comes.
But he does have help. Half the people working in Rushville's hospital are Doc Doner babies.
We all have times in our lives where we try to do the right thing and then we burn out. He's been doing this for 55 years.
Well, I think because every day he makes a difference to at least one person.
Susan Park runs his office on Sundays and holidays.
She shows up when I show up.
Slide right under your tongue.
For free, okay. As does her husband, Rick, who Doc saved from a swarm of hornets.
I wouldn't have been able to do any of the things that I've done so far, so me mowing his yard once a week, I figure pays it back.
Russell Doner was in the Army during World War II, the last time he took a day off, but knows exactly what he'd do if he took another.
I would like to go to Missouri someday.
58 miles away.
Missouri's not too far from here.
Well, no, but then if you, it takes a little time to do it.
He'd rather work on his hobby, trees. Doc's donated 10,000 around town.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Dr. Doner has no children of his own. He married only briefly. But he's delivered 3,500 babies, more than Rushville's population. There are no statues to his kind of devotion, just lives.
I can make it all right.
Because the town looks after him. For today, Bob Dodson, NBC News, with an American story in Rushville, Illinois.
Wow, that's really something, that's making a difference story, yeah. Every day of your life.
Yeah, oh. $5 a visit.
Bless his heart. Yeah. Oh, dear. Well, that's a great story from Bob Dodson. And on that note, we have much more still ahead this morning, including how to tell if you or your spouse is actually...